Hello everybody, Angel Arts here, and welcome back to another brand new Let's Play. Today we are going to be doing To the Moon. I wanted to do a few more of these mini LPs for you guys amidst my longer LP that is Dragon Age Inquisition and The Sims 4, I think is still going on. There's a whole bunch of things that are going on, but I wanted to try to sprinkle in a few new games just for variety's sake, because now I know not everybody is into Inquisition or into Sims 4, so hopefully there'll be something in there that you're interested in. So, To the Moon, I have absolutely no idea what this game is about, but it's been highly recommended to me for a lot of people. Apparently, this is a very emotional game, which is why I'm doing face cam again. More specifically, my coworker, as well as RockyBeastenderTartine and Alexandra, have all begged me to LP this game blindly. Are you happy now, Alexandra? I'm fine. I told you I was gonna do it. So I finally was able to get it in. It's actually right now Christmas morning, Christmas 2014 morning. I'm going to be visiting family. Family's getting together later this evening. So I just had enough time, I think, to hopefully get through this game in one sitting. And yeah, so let's go ahead and begin without further ado. I'm excited. I've been wanting to play this game for a while. It's an older game, but I hear it's still a great experience. So let's try this out. Original music, Khan Gao, Laura Shihigara. Cool. So far the presentation reminds me of the Super NES, which I hold a very close, you know, spot in my heart. Super NES is one of the best Nintendo systems, in my opinion. Classic. So we have a little girl playing on the piano. I love the soundtrack. What the? What just happened? Oh my gosh. Looks like nobody got hurt. Dr. Rosaline. What are you doing, Neil? Dr. Watts. Well, excuse me for heroically evading that squirrel coming out of nowhere. Dr. Rosaline. You ran over it anyways. Oh. You ran over it and hit a tree. Look, don't worry. It's a company car. Are you kidding me? The boss is going to kill us! We'll just say I was saving a puppy. Yeah, there we go. He likes puppies, right? He's more of a cat person. Why does the world have to be so complicated? Fine. Whatever furball he fancies, crisis... I'm sorry, it's Dr. Watts. Fine. Whatever furball he fancies, crisis averted. Good. Go write that on your report later. Let's grab the equipment from the car and move already. Left click on an object to interact with it. Received equipment. Got the sucker. Let's roll. I was trying to look at the squirrel, not the equipment. Right click the toggle menu or cancel. Characters. Patient offline. This is interesting. Dr. Neil Watts, Technician Specialist, Sigmund Corps. Dr. Eva Rosaline, Senior Memory Traversal Agent, Sigmund Corps. Memory Traversal? Notes, items, equipment. With a box this heavy, what's inside has got to be important. I guess I'll save. For now. No, I don't want to cancel the game. Escape to go back, I guess? There we go. Oh, come on. I crashed the car while trying to evade it. What more do you want? Not crash the car and evade it? That's asking too much. Does he say the same thing? I blame it on the car. Who put the driver's seat on the right side, anyway? Only if you're in certain countries. So I can have them move around. At least they move really quickly. Whee! So is this like, it's like a RPG point and click kind of? That leads me up there. What's in the sign? What does the sign say? Wiles household head. Putting up a sign when they live in the middle of nowhere is like asking to be robbed. The Wiles household. Are those kids the Wiles kids? A smoking hot car. Yeah, smoking hot. Exactly. I get it, game. I get it. Can't put one over on me. So I guess we're gonna advance to the next. The sign to the house points to the other way. Oh, how kind of it to exist. I like the humor in this game. Alright, well there was a big glowing arrow that was calling me. Hey, wait, don't forget the car. Just wanted to see if you'd remember. How thoughtful of you. Can I click on the bird? Interesting. I'm not sure. Let's see. I'm trying to make sure I don't miss anything. I don't see anything in particular. Who put a boulder here? Maybe it's their security system. Cucumbers. We don't have time for this fluff. Cucumbers? Let's try pushing it out of the way. Maybe we could find a tree branch to jack it with. Wait. Or we could just call it a night and blame it on that. Push it by hand, find a branch, abort mission, go home. Let's find a branch. Branch will do. Oh. So. Oh, here we go, tree branch. Receive the tree branch. Let's try it. Alright, this better work. Oh, did that tree branch just melt the boulder? What was that? I don't even, or was it like an inflatable boulder? It's some kind of an air ball. Yeah, it was inflatable. Right. We need to get going for now. Right. Okay. That was interesting. Inflatable boulder. Squirrels, they're still alive though. They did not get killed by the horrible Dr. What's-a-Schmertz. No, I don't think he's horrible. I guess this is the kid's house? It must be, because the music stopped. Oh, there's a lighthouse thing. I saw that in the intro. Okay. And I don't think there's anything over here. All right. I don't think I can move that way. Okay. Let's go in the door and don't know what we're supposed to be doing here. We have a mission, apparently. The kids are still there. Ma, they're here. Not a bad place to retire at, huh? I could do better. Night shifts, love 'em or hate 'em? You know the answer, you stupid owl. It's probably going to be another all-nighter, you know. I know. Are they not letting them in? And I doubt they have any coffee. Shut up. And the ocean waves will sing lullabies. Not through your blathering, they won't. And your eyelids will. Don't forget the equipment, moron. Wow, these two. I don't get paid enough for this. Ooh, moonwalk. Moonwalk back in there. Good job. Act 1. I never told anyone, but I've always thought they were lighthouses. Okay, interesting. Lily. Dr. Watts and Dr. Rosaline, I presume? Thanks for coming on such a short notice.
That's okay. I tend to be bad at predicting deaths as well. Whoa! Predicting deaths.
Are you the patient's daughter? Oh no, I'm just his caretaker. And these are my children, Sarah and Tommy. It's not exactly a 9-to-5 job, so Johnny lets us live here. I suppose this Johnny is our man?
Johnny? Listen, if it's a kid we're dealing with, I don't think we're the ones you want.
No, no. He just prefers to be called that.
Yeah, don't expect... Why? I didn't automatically think Johnny was necessarily a kid.
He's upstairs right now with his medical doctor. Come with me.
Can I talk to the kids first? Can I wander around and not go to my main objective first, like I normally do with RPGs?
Come on, grab that and let's go.
When my back breaks one day, I'll sue you with an insurance claim. Receive the equipment. All right, let's head upstairs before I drop this.
No, I want to interact with things. Let's go talk to the kitties. I want to talk to the kitties.
Apparently we don't walk nearly as quickly as we do indoors as we do outdoors. The patient is waiting upstairs. Better not waste time.
But these things.
Oh, I'm not going to be able to go to any of these, am I? Can I play For River? Johnny H. Wiles. What kind of a song is this? It's just two notes repeated over and over. River. Am I not... look at the clock. It's... Wait. Okay, so it's 11... 11 something. Alright, up the stairs we go. Go upstairs? Yeah.
Okay, they're gone. Whoever gets there first gets to play the melody.
Now it's the boy's turn.
No fair, you pushed me. Did not. Whatever, you get the boring two notes anyway.
Two notes can do a lot, though, when you accompany with other notes, too. I really, really like... I'm really enjoying the soundtrack.
Those kids are pretty good for their age.
Hey, you're the one who said there was no time to waste. And incidentally, I'm the one who is carrying the weight of a small meteoroid.
Yeah, yeah, come on.
So we have a patient here who we're going to totally ignore and check out their artwork. A painting of a lighthouse by the cliffside. A painting of a woman holding something yellow and blue. A painting of an animal of some sort. A casual painting of three people. Maybe Johnny is one of those three people? He's unresponsive at this point, but by the looks of things, he's still consciously hanging on. It's hard to say how long he'll have, but I would hurry. I'll look over him. Go ahead and set up.
Ready to set up?
Look around first. Gee, you know, I think I'd like to carry this excruciatingly heavy object around some more. Thanks for asking, though. I love these too. Especially the one guy. Oh, but I need to use the bathroom first. Don't follow me to the bathroom. Okay, well. And there's the patient. Ready to set up? Sure, set the machine down. Yes, it'll just be a moment. Still not really. They're gonna tell us, I know, but I'm perplexed. I'm intrigued. Are you sure a common household power outlet is sufficient? No worries, we're the experts. Oh, snap. Standard procedures. Just keeping on your toes. What the heck is this device? How's he doing? Not so well. If I were to say he's got just a day or two left. That's plenty of time. So, you two can grant him any wish, huh? Whoa, you two can grant him any wish. To try, at least. But we always succeed, because we're awesome. So, what's the wish? The moon. Yeah, I figured that's what it was. He wants to go to the moon. The moon? The moon. He wants to go to the moon. The geezers just keep on getting crazier, huh? So, can you do it? It depends. Okay, so let me see if I can, if I can figure this out. So it's sounding like these people, because I forgot what the machine was called or what their professions was called, but based on their profession names, it's I feel like they go to people who are on their deathbed. And they try to give them one final wish before they pass on, by essentially making them dream, giving them some sort of virtual reality dream to experience whatever wish they want, as like a way for them to have one final joyous memory, one final joyous memory before they pass on. It's pretty interesting, if that's what this is. She meant to say yes. Why don't you tell us about our client? Why don't you tell us about our client here? That I don't really know much. Johnny's an old man. Through the 2 years that I've worked here, he rarely spoke. He worked as a craftsman for most of his life, and his wife passed away 2 years ago. I don't really know how many details. I would have known more if I were his paperboy, for Pete's sake. Shush, just do your thing. Well, I suppose if you look around the house, you may find some more info. Yeah, like the paintings. I suppose Johnny wouldn't mind, since he signed for you two. So be it. Let's go snoop around the house. All right, which one of us plays detective? Who goes to search the house? Player controlled. Dr. Watts or Rosaline? I feel like we've had Dr. Watts do a lot of, heavy lifting work already. Let's have Dr. Rosaline do this. Let Dr. Watts stay for a bit, sit down for a bit. Thanks for the offer, but I'm busy leaving a butt print on this chair. Right, do continue. Tommy and Sarah can show you around. They're probably at the piano downstairs. All right, well, maybe I can search around the bathroom first. Anything here? No, just the light. Okay. That's a pretty nice bathroom, I have to say. A selection of readings from medical journals. A selection of readings from medical journals. He is unresponsive at this point, but by the looks of things, he's still consciously hanging on. It's hard to say how long you'll have, but I would hurry. Shoo, go to your detective work. Tommy and Sarah can take you around the house if you need any assistance. They're probably downstairs at the piano. Okay. So we've got a lighthouse by the cliffside. Yellow and blue. Woman holding something yellow and blue. Painting of an animal of some sort. And a painting of three people. I'm wondering if those are clues to something. Wait! Come back here for a moment. I have something for you. Okay, why don't you give it to me when I spoke with you like 30 seconds ago? Here, take this. Received a remote patient monitor. That'll keep you updated on Johnny's status. Thanks, I was just going to ask for it. Johnny's heart monitor is now activated in menu. His heart monitor? Oh. Oh. So he doesn't have much time. Okay, I have a feeling that he's gonna go into critical critical condition if we don't, if we take our sweet time too much. What time is it now? Still the same. Wow, time hasn't didn't seem like time like advanced at all. Candy cane? Is that a candy cane up there? It looks like a candy cane. It's Christmas Day right now, and that looks to me like a candy cane. Nothing in there. Not sure if there's anything outside, maybe? I better ask those kids first. Oh, you're so polite. Go inside anyways. Now. Better ask those kids first. Going downstairs. No. And they're probably gonna say the same thing. Oh no. Bathroom. Cool. Don't need to have permission to go to the bathroom. Turn on tap store tap water and store tap water? Yeah. Alright. That might be useful later. Let's go talk to these two. What you want? Show around the house. Sarah and Tommy, right? Your mother said to ask you too to show me around the house. Okay, maybe we will. Maybe. I think we just need a little convincing, that's all. Oh boy, the snotty brats. What do you think, Tommy? Yeah! What would you like? We want $1 trillion! Of course you do. Or the candy cane mom hides from us. It is a candy cane! Yeah, or that. Huh? There is a giant candy cane on top of a high shelf that we can't reach. It's in the kitchen. Ma put it there to save for when we do chores. Get it for us, and we'll give you a tour of the house. What do you say? Well, sure, I'll go get it for you. No, cut to help. I'll get it for you. My mother used to keep candies on high shelves too. All right, I'll go get it. The kitchen's door is right next to the stairs. Now go. Bratty little kids. It's all right. Can we reach the top of that? I guess we can. There's that candy cane. You need a chair or something. Chair. Or use that. Sure. Might as well get that candy cane for them while I'm here. Yeah, I know. I'm trying to. There you go. Receive the candy cane. Yay! Terrible calories. Well, if you just do this over and over again, you'll be able to burn some of those calories, dear. All right. Come on, you greedy brats. Okay, I got what you wanted. Good old candy cane. If you come and give me a tour at this instant, I won't sneeze on it. Okay, where do we start? I know, there's this funny room in the basement. I don't like that funny room. What do you mean by funny room? You'll see. It's weird. We need to get the keys, though. The old man hid it inside a book in the study. A book in the study. Oh, so we have all the companions. Doctor, okay, senior memory traversal. There it is, see, memory traversal agent Sigma Corps. Tommy, doesn't like turtles. Sarah, aspiring professional ice cream taster, aiming for the top. Love it, love it. Let's go and save. No notes, remote patient. Can I actually type in notes? No, I can't. Connects wirelessly to the patient's local monitor for live supervision. Okay. So there's a study in the study is... This isn't the study, this is just the living room. Is it? Alright. Is the study the same as their bedroom? Because I know there's a book here. Selection reads for medical journals. Maybe the study is in another part of the house that we haven't visited yet. Ma says not to go in that room. But our bunk's in there, now we can't sleep. Ma says not to go in that room today. Which is awesome because we can stay up late. Alright. Maybe this is the study. Probably is, because that's the only other room left. You can't go downstairs, apparently. This is the book's room. The key to the funny room is in the thickest book on the upper shelf. Tommy used to throw books at me and call it a book fight. Book fight. Until one day, I threw one back and he needed a band-aid. I wonder if Johnny has actually read all of these books. Just a bunch of books in here. They've got nothing I don't know about, though. Really, now? Me and Sarah used to have book fights until one of us needed a band-aid. Ma told us to stop, but we do it anyway. Oh, kids. Kids. The Emperor's New Clothes by Hans Christian Andersen. Read a passage. And the colors. The colors of that beautiful fabric. I've never seen anything like it in my life. They all tried to conceal their disappointment at not being able to see the clothes. A child, however, who had no important role and could only see things as his eyes showed them to him, went up to the carriage. But he hasn't got anything on, the child. But he hasn't got anything on, the child said. Don't talk nonsense, his father reprimanded. But the boy's remark, which has been heard by the bystanders, was repeated over and over. Dusklight, the tale of a girl who fell in love with a zombie. Who Dusklight? It's like Twilight. Dusklight, the tale of a girl who fell in love with a zombie who emitted the smell of daisies when showered with a gentle sunlight. Oh, that's so great. Read a passage. Sure. Maybe another year. Receive the room key. He chose its hiding spot well. Because nobody would look in there. Okay, guys, I'm going to have to end this episode here. Thanks for watching the introduction to Let's Play to the Moon. Tune in next time, folks. And until then, love yourselves and love each other.